Smith born to ride a stallion across the English countryside in a leather coat with his hair blowing in the wind? Yes. The answer is yes. Check out the A-lister in Surrey, England, filming scenes for his upcoming film, The Huntsman, due to hit screens in 2016. And even though he looks good up there and once played the superhero that was the God of Thunder, he must have left his hammer at home because somebody had to lend him an umbrella to protect his beautifully flowing locks. Guess we can't really blame him. If we looked like that, we'd be doing the same thing. The upcoming film also stars Charlize Theron and Emily Blunt. And we hope we get pictures of them atop of a horse pretty soon, but until then, Chris will have to deal.
Few places capture the mind, body, and soul like magical Marrakech. And there are countless celebrity fans to prove this. International jet setters Victoria and David Beckham love the city. After renewing their vows there in 2008, the pair decided it would be the ideal location to celebrate David's 40th birthday in style. Flying in their celebrity friends Liv Tyler, Eva Longoria, and fellow Spice Girls Mel C and Emma Bunton for an exclusive party. As well as partying in their exclusive resort, they even ventured out for some sightseeing. Supermodel Poppy Delevingne was so captivated by Marrakech, she held a second wedding ceremony there when she married her husband James Cook, taking over the infamous La Mamonia Hotel with the help of her famous bridesmaids Sienna Miller and her supermodel sister Cara Delevingne. Reality TV star and budding fashion designer Millie Makcintosh is such a fan of the Moroccan city that as well as visiting for pleasure, she also chose it as the backdrop for a fashion shoot for her latest collection. And X Factor judge Cheryl Cole even picked it as her judge's house location back in 2009. With all these celebrity endorsements, we suggest you jump on a magic carpet and fly off to Marrakech. And don't forget to pack your autograph books.
Hi, my name is Moran Atias, and I'm on the show Tyrant on FX. And you're watching Celebrity Bites on Splash TV.
I wanted time with you, myself, before my husband is going to do whatever he's going to do to you.
I had to stop him, Layla, before he did something that you and I couldn't fix.
Between the two of you, you are the monster. This is your democracy, deposing presidents. You can forget about democracy, Bassam. We'll give them a show if that's what they want. An election. But then, Jamal will rule this country for the rest of his life.
I play Layla Fayed. She is the First Lady of Abu Dhabi, a fictional Arab country set in the Middle East. I think her hopes and dreams are to take her country into a more Western-inspired society, but yet maintaining the tradition and culture of her backgrounds. But she finds extreme challenges within the palace, dealing with her husband, who is the president of the country, and the threats that terrify the palace from so many different angles. I was born and raised in Israel, and constantly you hear criticism of people from all different cultures and countries about a country they've never visited and they've never been part of and they have never lived under threat. So they can't really know. Unless you live in those shoes, unless you are put in those circumstances, you can truly understand and perhaps sympathize, perhaps criticize, but only then form an opinion. I think that because I'm from that part of the world, I felt a certain responsibility and privilege to tell that, to be part of the story, because it's definitely a courageous and controversial storytelling that we're putting on screen and an American screen about a part of the world that is so many times not only misunderstood, but ununderstood, because it's so different and we're all different. And I think what the show is doing so well is telling the story in a compelling way. Season two is epic. It's there's so many things that are happening that are changing every character in a profound way. We are constantly facing devastating choices, which will determine the future of the country, but also the dynamics within the family. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Moran Atias. You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter, Moran Atias. And I'd love you to watch my new show called Tyrant on FX every Tuesday, 10. 10 p.m.
Don't worry, folks. When Ashton Kutcher and Mila Kunis finally said, "I do," Jon Cryer was there, and he could not think of any reason those two should not get married. The 2.5 Men star took to Twitter to announce that less than a year ago, he and Ashton were married on national TV, and that maybe Mila will succeed where he failed. He then reminded everyone that yes, he was in attendance, but he did not make a scene, and they were all very mature about it. Ashton and Mila exchanged vows at the Secret Garden at Parrish Ranch in Oak Glen, California over the 4th of July weekend, and they reportedly housed guests in luxury tents on the ranch, which of course they dubbed Camp Cuckoo. We're even learning that the couple's 9-month-old daughter Wyatt also played a role in the ceremony, and Ashton spent most of the day carrying her around in his arms. Guess our invite got lost in the mail.